I'm Stephen, welcome to Steety Films. The second year for the Nintendo Switch has been quite promising, but now we're starting to see some really cool free-to-play games starting to build up on the Nintendo Switch. So here are my top 5 free-to-play games on Nintendo Switch, now let's get to it. Right, my Nintendo Switch needs charging, I want to discuss some disclaimers. So do keep in mind, as this recording, and there are only like 5 plus odd free-to-play games, but it's a good enough number now to make like a video about free-to-play games for the Nintendo Switch as it is. Let alone Bethesda and their somewhat mobile games jumping on board like Fallout Shelter, as well as Elder Scrolls Legends that'll be coming out some point, I guess, this year on other platforms as well, even though their upcoming, you know, Elder Scrolls Blades that they're working on mobile platform at the moment, but hopefully that might come to the Switch, maybe. Hint, hint. But yeah, despite only mentioning Bethesda and what tiles they're working on the Nintendo Switch side of things, I'd rather mention some other games as it is. Anyways, quit the jibber jabber, let's get on with number 5, and that's Kitten Squad. Even though this does look a bit dull, but it actually runs quite good, and it's basically like a Binder Isaac kind of clone. Even I was tempted to get Binder Isaac or run into the Gungeon on my Nintendo Switch, alone double dipping, it's all a different topic. But it's just in this, however, being a free-to-play game, it's nice to play a similar game and add to double dip in somewhat way. Now, sure, it looks bad and somewhat performs alright, but it still looks really, really good and a really cool free-to-play game, I should say. And the only cosmetics then is microtransactions or different thing. You basically just get the full cosmetic, you know, you can play as a kitten, a crocodile, any sort of animals. Why can't we just call this Kitten Squad and Friends? But anyways, it's cool though that the only microtransaction side of things was just mostly cosmetics, and the game itself would have been like £5 odd, but it's nice that the base game itself is free to play, which is good. So that's number 5, and at number 4 is Pinball FX3. Now, there are quite a few pinball free-to-play games on the Blue Nintendo Switch as it is, but however, Pinball FX3 is somewhat a go-to kind of game that I've been playing since the other platforms have been playing the Pinball FX series. Even this was my very first free-to-play game on the Nintendo Switch, despite though, and double dipping is another thing, it's easy to double dip games when it comes to free-to-play games. Let alone during the time when this game was launched on the Nintendo Switch, there was quite a good offer where basically I got a few extra tables for free, and I also got on different platforms with the same offer, and just reasons why I kind of purchased this, well not saying purchased, download the game for free on my Nintendo Switch, being my first free-to-play game on Nintendo Switch. But still, however, even though you just get the one table when you download the base free-to-play game, it's still a good replayability, regardless of just having the one table. I know most of the tables regards on franchises, I should say, and reasons why it has microtransactions in somewhat way, just to buy more tables and different franchises from ones you know and love. But this one's an off-skill one, but I'm so used to it, and I play so much in regards to playing the same table on other platforms in different, you know, Pinball FX series, I should say. So that's number 4, and at number 3 is Pokemon Quest. Even with the Pokemon series, there's quite a number of spin-off series for the Pokemon franchise, regards on similar games like Pokemon Mystery Dungeon and Pokemon Rumble Worlds, etc. But this is a neat new Pokemon spin-off game, I should say, let alone using somewhat mechanics, power level up system, so you know how to fight against other stronger Pokemon. It's a good way, then it's all the perks in regards and level. It's just got a unique system, is what I'm trying to say. Even as tradition with Pokemon games, there's quite a bit of grinding to do with gaining certain perks for your Pokemon as such. Let alone there is an auto feature where basically you can actually do stuff in the background while playing the game still in somewhat way. that I don't kind of recommend, even with the microtransaction side of things. There's not quite heavily, honestly, to say. And sure, there's like a ticket system and a battery system, nonetheless, but at least you can still do some stuff in the meantime, in between switching games, I should say. There's playing games in the background. But everyone likes a good grind, that's all I always say. So that's number three, and at number two is Fortnite. It has to be mentioned at some point, but sure, it's a popular, overrated game, but it's such a quite a good achievement getting this game, a popular game to exact, on the Nintendo Switch, let alone. I'm sure it doesn't perform very well, and it does perform somewhat well on 30fps, it's all a different topic. But you know, it's just things like this on the Nintendo Switch is really, really good, I should say. Let alone the origins of Fortnite, but again, no, it's great to have this game on the Nintendo Switch, even though a free-to-play game as it is on the Nintendo Switch. Despite the microtransactions, but it's mostly cosmetics, which is good for microtransactions. It has to be cosmetics, let alone, it's a good thing you're not getting, like, a legendary or rare weapon to influence the game in somewhat way. It's a good thing it's not, like, power-based, and it's at least it's cosmetics, let alone dance moves, all a different topic. Even though Battle Royale games are becoming like a more of a thing now, but it's nice that we'll get to somewhat free-to-play game, and the only Battle Royale game at the moment as this recording for Nintendo Switch, despite free-to-play and Battle Royale as it is. So that's number two, and at number one is... Yes, Paladins. Now do keep in mind I'm playing this on my Xbox despite it's not free to play as of yet until later on this summer as this recording, but nonetheless, yes, Paladins. Like Doom or Wolfenstein for that matter, it's such an achievement to get a first person shooter game like this on the Nintendo Switch and kind of full 60 frames per second for a first person shooter game on the Nintendo Switch is a really good achievement. Sure, it's not Overwatch on the Nintendo Switch, but it's the closest thing we can get until, like, and you know, Blizzard end up doing Overwatch for the Nintendo Switch. But either way, this is good enough despite a free-to-play game, a free-to-play, nearly 60fps, first-person shooter game is really, really good to have this sort of game on the Nintendo Switch. Even the microtransactions, again, are not mostly cosmetics, but basically picking certain heroes, even though most of the heroes you get when you first get the base game, but there's quite a number of heroes, because it's the same thing when it comes to the previous game, which is Smite, where you have to buy like the god bundle to get all the gods first hand. It is a bit of a thing when it comes to free to play games, because certain fighting games have like this thing like here's the base game, here's one fire and all that jazz. It's similar and really good ways to do these sort of free to play games and convince you to buy certain things within the game's base game. But nonetheless, as is recorded, and looking forward to this game being free to play on the Nintendo Switch, even though that I recently reinstalled it on my Xbox One, despite it's nice to have that Xbox One X enhancements, but you know, just reasons why I think I'll play more on my Nintendo Switch, let alone a game like this and all that jazz on the Nintendo Switch is such a great thing that I might play on my Nintendo Switch more than my Xbox. So that's my top 5 free to play games on the Nintendo Switch, hope you'll enjoy it. Now, sure, other platforms have a huge library of free-to-play games, but it's a great start for the Nintendo Switch, even though it's 5+ games, but it's a really good start, nonetheless, even though big titles, nonetheless, and I just hope the Nintendo Switch does well for free-to-play games, little mobile blooming games, you know, so mobile free-to-play games might end up on the Nintendo Switch eventually. But looking forward to, even with them year 2 for the Nintendo Switch, I'm looking forward to loads of particular free-to-play games that might, start building up on the Nintendo Switch. Sure, the limitations of the Nintendo Switch, but it's great, though, to see certain titles as we come along, and hopefully we'll get some real more tiles despite the limitations on the Nintendo Switch. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.